So you've come.
Oh, you guys showed up a lot faster than I expected. Not fast enough, though. Time's not really on our side here.
Crow?
You're here after all.
You made it plenty clear that we didn't have a choice in the matter. That said, it's good to see you again. You too, Duvali. Thanks for taking the time to meet with us.
Well, what's with the casual hello? We are not friends. Your thanks is nothing more than a pittance to me. Personally, I'd rather not have to see this sordid scene play itself out. But this is the path I've chosen.
Sordid scene?
What does she mean by that?
Well, now that we've got both Class 7s all nice and gathered here, I'll tell you everything I know about the rivalries.
Already? No warm-up monologue or anything?
I'm just glad we're able to get straight to the heart of the matter for once.
All right, then. I'm all ears. Tell me what you know about this tension within me, within us. I feel it in the air, in the world itself. I feel my heart racing, steeling itself for some inevitable clash it awaits.
The world itself?
I see. So that's how it works.
Sounds like the little lady's got it all figured out. I get the feeling Gaius, Sarah, Emma, and Miss Kitty over there are on the right track, too. Simply put, the rivalries are a struggle for power. Death matches between divine knights, as the world is driven to the brink of annihilation.
That's madness!
I knew it!
I saw the parallels with what Vita attempted at the Infernal Castle 2 years ago. Her goal was to trigger a pseudo-rivalry, wasn't it?
Then there's the experiments Ouroboros conducted with the three Ions over the course of the past year. They were trying to see if the rivalries could be artificially reproduced, is that right?
Yes. I was never privy to the particulars, but they were seeking to awaken the tremendous power brought forth by the fusion of the two Septarians. The experiments were a means to that end. A bid to turn melees into miracles.
That more or less covers it. Vita's been searching for ages for a way to keep the curse in check. The curse of the Great One, the catalyst of the great twilight that ushers in the end of the world. All those clashes between the Divine Knights in the past have just been dress rehearsals at best. As orbital technology advanced, the day soon came when humanity's weapons were powerful enough to conceivably cause the end of the world. And with that, the conditions to begin the rivalry of the Seven were met.
You can't be serious. So it's not that the rivalries are the cause of the world ending.
It's that the rivalries can only occur as the world's being ravaged by war.
And perhaps it'd help to see the world as a sort of crucible. The Great Twilight is the kindling, and war, the bellows that stoke its infernal flame. The further the extent of its strife, the hotter the blaze. As the crucible drowns in fire, the Seven, who were once one, begin their battle within. From there they fight to the death, melting into each other amongst the flames, one by one, until finally, the Seven are reforged into a whole once more.
Come again?
It's somewhat akin to the practices of the alchemists of old, distilling materials into their purest form.
It sounds more to me like a survival of the fittest, a battle royale with one singular victor.
It's both. But on a far larger, far more primal scale than anything we've ever known.
Well, shit.
Seems like this is ringing some bells for you. No surprise there. You're an awakener and a sacrifice. A two-for-one package. You know exactly what it is we have to do. We can feel it in our bones.
So you mean
you're starting the rivalry right here? Right now?
I'm no Vita, but I know a prime opportunity when I see one. The war hasn't started yet. Maybe if we get a jump on this, we can derail the gnome's plans. But the second the Empire launches its attack on the Republic...
As the sacrifice, I'd be forced to engage in the rivalries, whether I like it or not. That's all there is to it, right?
Rean!
The curse would take over.
Nail on the head. You'd either go berserk, or your memories would get sealed away, turning you into a mindless puppet. It's one side of the coin, or the other.
Then now may be the last chance I have, before my memories are snatched away, before I'm forced to duel to the death, devoid of all sense and reason. I can still see this rivalry through with my own eyes. Triumph or fail by my own merit. I stand before you, Crow, as a swordsman of the Eight Leaves and a member of Class 7. Even if it's the last thing I ever do, I'll do so as myself. Rean Schwarzer.
Instructor Rean.
Ah, there you go.